Hi guys! Because of the extremely popular demand, I am going to take a few minutes to describe to you the specificities of the connectivity between a Dangerous DBox and a Universal Audio Apollo straight from the moon. This is just to show you what is special about the Apollo plus DBox combo. Let's look at the back of this affair. You might notice a few things about my existing setup. First, you might notice that my computer is made by a fruit company. Second, you might notice that I've already connected my speakers to the DBox speaker outputs. And here, the firewire cable is going from the fruit computer all the way around to the Apollo. That is the data connection between the computer and the Apollo. I am not going to go over the summing setup because you can look at that in the DBox video, but I'm still going to connect it so we can listen to music later. In the Apollo, the outputs are here. Let's speed up. All right, so that's done. Now I have to set up the sum output of the DBox back into the DAW. Sum output is here. The inputs are over there. I'm going to choose input 1 and 2. All right. And now our traditional digital out of the interface into the DAW input of the DBox. In this case, it's SPDIF. The output is right here. And the DAW input is right here. So far, this is old news with new cables, but it gets more interesting. The Apollo happens to have 8 plus 2 outputs. 8 plus 2 in most cultures is 10, but I still like to say 8 plus 2 because the extra two outputs are dedicated monitoring outputs. Let me show you. First, I'm going to connect the extra two outputs, the plus 2, into the analog input of the DBox. You will recognize the extra two outputs in the Apollo because they have extra white labeling right here. So you can tell them in the dark, which is kind of neat. I'll tell you more about these two outputs in a second. Here's what we have so far. It's a traditional analog summing setup for DBox, which is 8 outputs in TRS format coming out of the Apollo into the sum input of the DBox, which is in DSUB format. The sum output of the DBox, which is in XLR format, going into two inputs of the Apollo TRS format. Then, the SPDIF output of the Apollo is going into the DAW input of the DBox. And, as an added bonus, special Apollo connection, the monitor out of the Apollo go into the analog input of the DBox. Let me show you how to use all that stuff. This knob is originally intended to be the monitor control for the Apollo, but only one set of speakers and no source switching. That's why we have a DBox combo. You need to put it on stun all the way up. So essentially, we are taking these monitor outputs and turning them into another pair of line level outputs. Now, if you remember, in a traditional DBox analog summing setup, we tend to use the SPDIF output of the interface and select the DAW input here on the DBox. Here's what's different about the Apollo. By default, there is an Apollo console preference that says SPDIF mirrors monitor 1-2. What that means is that whatever you send to the monitor outs of the Apollo is copied to the SPDIF out. What does that mean for you with your DBox? Two things. Number one, it means that in your DAW, you are not going to send your main output to your SPDIF outputs. You're going to send your main output to what the Apollo calls control room outputs. That in turn will automatically get copied to the SPDIF out of the Apollo. That does not happen at the DAW level, it happens at the Apollo level. Why should you care about all this? Because I'm going to show you a tracking setup and a mixing setup. Let's talk about tracking first. Here's the Apollo console. First things first, you can only think of this console as an input console. It does nothing for your outputs. Don't try and see something on this console when you're sending something to output 1 or output 2. You will see nothing here. Remember that. If you want to know if something is coming out of the Apollo, look at these meters up here. Those are your monitoring meters. Now that that's clear, here's the beauty about the system. Since the Apollo is a real-time tracking system, meaning there's no latency, you want to listen to the output of this console while you're tracking. Remember what we did when we set up. We took the analog monitoring outputs of the Apollo, which are real-time because they're all analog. We put them on stun here turn them into a line level set of outputs and plug them into the analog input of the D-Box. So right now, if I hit the analog input of the D-Box, I can listen to the output of the UAD console in real time with no latency. I repeat, in real time with no latency. Why? Because this is a fully analog setup. You're taking advantage of the real-time capabilities of the Apollo and of the fact that there's an analog input on the D-Box, okay? So for tracking, you are listening to this console in real time through the analog input of the D-Box. What that means is that you're going to do your main cue system with the faders on the Apollo input console. Listen to it on the D-Box, which means you can have it on your speakers and you can have it on your two sets of headphone outputs on the D-Box. All that without compromising the fact that you can still use the two built-in cue systems of the Apollo that show up here on the console. If you need to overdub anything, really nothing changes because the universal audio console merges the monitor outputs of the DAW with the real-time inputs of the console in real time. As far as the D-Box goes, nothing changes. So there you have it. For tracking, you use the analog input of the D-Box and everything is in real time with no latency. For mixing, switch to the DAW input of the D-Box. As you remember, we connected the SPDIF out of the Apollo into the DAW input of the D-Box. The point of this is to be able to use the built-in mastering style D2A converter of the D-Box as your reference converter, and to do some cool source switching tricks, like for example, say if you have an iPod dock, you can put it here, connect it into the other digital input of the D-Box, which is called CD, but you can plug just about anything in it. CDs are dead, by the way. They've been replaced by this thing. So now, I can have reference music playing on my iPod or whatever digital source I have on the side and listen to it hitting CD. And then I can have my music coming out of my DAW, my current mix, and I can listen to it by hitting the DAW. So now I can compare both sets of material through the same converter by just hitting one button, which is a lot easier than switching applications and starting iTunes and stopping iTunes and coming back. This is a much more natural and efficient way to A/B stuff and through the same converter. Here's another cool thing about mixing with an Apollo and a D-Box. If you remember, we connected the sum output of the D-Box into input 1-2 of the Apollo. Input 1-2 show up here. Why don't we use a 33609 compressor in real time on my sum return? This is the same as having hardware in the path, except it's plugins. So for example, say I want to compress my whole mix by the 33609. Since the sum output of the D-Box is connected to the input 1-2 of the Apollo, I'm able to insert this plugin on input 1-2 in real time on the Apollo, and that's going to get recorded by my DAW, no latency. So not only are you leveraging all 8 outputs of the Apollo instead of just 2 traditionally by using the analog summing capabilities of the D-Box, but you are also using the real-time processing capabilities of the Apollo on your D-Box summing output. Side note for this trick, do make sure if you're going to use real-time processing on your sum outputs to mute this monitor here. Why is that? Because this is the input, it's real-time, it gets merged with the DAW output. So if you don't mute it, you're going to hear both the DAW output and the return. You don't want that. So whenever you're doing this trick of using the real-time processing of the Apollo for your sum output, just mute the cue system. That's it. Lastly, if you are familiar with traditional native DAW systems, you'll know that when the singer wants to re-record the third verse towards the end of the mixing session, it's a problem because all those plugins you put on during the mix create a lot of latency. Then they complain they can hear themselves twice. It's a problem. Not with this rig, because all you have to do is press the analog button, you're back in real time, because the analog button monitors the cue output of the UAD console, which merges your current mixes with no changes with the real-time monitoring capabilities of the console, so your singer can do it again and again and again and again. Et voilà! Thanks for watching this brief overview of what's special about connecting a Dangerous D-Box with a Universal Audio Apollo straight from the moon.